must be a prisoner. You look just like a prisoner.
The world's best omelet pan. It's a Manicot pan. No, it's for blintzes. Ah, palachintas. Introducing the International Gourmet Pan. It's all of these things and a lot more. This amazing gourmet pan can be used with or without shortening of any kind, and nothing sticks. Watch how this burnt food disappears with a wipe of a paper towel. You'll never have to scour again. Use it to cook hamburgers in their natural juices. You'll really taste the difference. When making cheese omelets or grilled cheese sandwiches, there's no messy cleanup. Even melted cheese will not stick to the gourmet pan. Just look how this egg slides around, as if on roller skates, and without a drop of shortening of any kind. It's a must for every kitchen. But when it comes to crepes, palachintas, manicots, or blintzes, the gourmet pan is unbelievable. Just heat pan to moderate temperature, pour on your mix, pour off excess, wait 30 seconds, and out pop perfect crepes, palachintas, blintzes, and manicot in no time flat. The International Gourmet Pan really puts the fun into cooking. And remember, with its amazing no-stick finish, there's never any mess to clean up. The amazing Gourmet Magic Pan can be yours for only $5.99. That's right, only $5.99. And it comes complete with this recipe book that contains 50 special easy-to-make recipes. And if you order now, you'll also receive this special freezer storage container at no extra cost. Almost a million of these pans were sold for $9.95 each, but on this special TV closeout, you pay only $5.99 or two pans for just $9.99. At this special price, when they're sold, there'll be no more. Here's how to get yours.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-228-3300. 1-800-228-3300. Save COD, send $5.99 for one pan, $9.99 for two pans to Amazing Pan, Box A, 3731, Chicago, Illinois. That's Amazing Pan, Box A, 3731, Chicago. Or if you wish, call toll-free 1-800-228-3300. That's toll-free 1-800-228-3300.
Entire population of the state of Utah, or the cast of
Eight is Enough.
Yeah, I was just gonna. Well, we have a star of the Dream Merchants here, Fernando Lamas.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, I don't have to. Also, a lot of people in it. Boy, this is a 4-hour movie. The history of the business begins in 1915 all the way to today.
Oh,
there's some good
Harold
people.
Harold Robbins
yeah. Book, right.
You play a nice fellow in this one?
No, yes and no. And my wife kills me because she finds me in bed with the wrong woman, but that's all right. That is a fact. I played the motion picture director of that era. Great people in it. Joe Ferrer is in it.
Yeah.
Vince Gardiner is in it. Red Buttons. All kinds of marvelous people.
Yeah.
Robert Culp.
Yeah.
And then a bunch of wonderful young people in it, too.
The Dream Merchants. You don't know when that's going to be out, do you?
No, we are just about to finish it now, so
we will find out, and we'll talk about it on the air.
All right. We'll bring all of them.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's right. Betty, you sang so beautifully.
Yeah. The tears were rolling out. That's really
she did it for you because she's always been very reluctant to sing on TV. She would never do it. And when she heard she was going to be on the Dinah Shore show, she said, "Okay, I'll do it." She says,
"Oh, Dick, that's very
and it's a real treat."
She's coming back, and we're going to do some Texas and Tennessee songs.
Oh, I'd love to.
You know, Texas used to be a part of Tennessee.
Oh, come on.
She was trying.
Oh, was it? Just because it's
Texas
bigger.
Girl, right?
I see. Oh, that was just exquisite.
Goosebumps.
You have an interesting clause in your contract with Eight is Enough. that carry. I mean, really, that's one of the reasons that was in your honor that day.
Thank you very much.
Tell them about the clause.
Well, I've been studying meditation and yoga for several years now, and I've been in the process of becoming a complete vegetarian. Susan was first, and then I changed my life and became a vegetarian. And so last year, I was a bit embarrassed that I was a vegetarian, having to stand in front of the Thanksgiving turkey, you know, and have our pictures made and stuff, and it just didn't feel right, because I just had such a sense of the turkey as a live creature. You know,
oh,
that,
dear.
You know. So I had them write in my contract this year in the renegotiation this spring that they couldn't have me shoot any of the dinner scenes with meat or poultry dishes or anything. So they have to serve Susan and I and some of the other people on the show only vegetables, and I don't have to stand in front of any more Thanksgiving or Christmas turkeys.
And they do a heck of a job.
Yeah. It's called the turkey clause.
Oh, God. For turkey, you can have spaghetti. I suppose they put you in front of the cranberry jelly. That'd be all right.
Who said you have to have turkey? You can have anything.
But see, the only thing is that I always wondered about, like, no one approves of murder. Like, if you asked me to play a murderer on TV, would it be right for me to say, well, no, I won't play a murderer because I don't believe in it? Isn't it almost the same thing? I mean, can't you portray something that you don't believe in?
I think it's a matter of the personal taste. I think if that's the way you feel, that's what you should do. And if you feel that you shouldn't do something, then you shouldn't. There are some parts that I wouldn't want to play. That doesn't matter. You know, my career is not. I have a life. You know, and it's about reverence for other lives, and that's first. And beyond that, if I can use my career to make that statement, I'll do that. And if my career has an antithetical statement to that, then I can't do it, because it's just in my own heart. But I think everybody, just their obligation is to be true to their own heart, and that's it.
Yeah.
Well, when are you running for office?
That's a great family argument.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.